We're done working with exponents for now, but we'll come back to them later. Let's look at some other ways that we can use decimals. We're going to look at decimals and percents. Decimals and percents are often used in currency and in commercial business. We can buy shoes, sweaters, or electronics on sale, and we often want to know how much does something actually cost. By the end of this segment, you'll be able to find out how much an item cost, like a new pair of shoes. So here's the problem that we're going to have you answer and come back to later. A pair of shoes cost $80 and is on sale for 44% off. What will you pay for the shoes? The first thing we need to recognize is this problem has a percent in it. Percent literally means per 100 or out of 100. I can write 44% another way. I know it's 44 out of 100 or 44 divided by 100. 44 divided by 100 is the same thing as 44 hundredths. Here's a grid of 100 squares, or I have one block. Of these 100 pieces, I'm going to have 44 of them. So I'd have 10, 20, 30, 40, 44 blocks out of 100, or 44 hundredths. And that's this written as a decimal, 44 hundredths. Okay, here are some other percents. I could have 23%, 6%, or 200%. I'm going to convert these percents to decimals. Sometimes we need to convert percents to decimals in order to use them in problems or to multiply. Okay, so let's use these 100 blocks to help us out. Here I have 23 squares shaded out of 100. So 23 divided by 100. As a decimal, that's 23 hundredths. For 6%, I'm going to have 6 blocks out of 100. So I have 6 blocks out of 100, or 6 hundredths, 0.06. Notice that the 6 has to be in the hundredth spot. For 200%, I know that I have to do something different. I could color in 100 of the squares in this one block. So I have 100 blocks shaded, but I need 200%. This is only 100 out of 100. That's 100%. 200% means 200 out of 100. I know one of these squares represents a hundredth, so I have 200 hundredths. Or I just have 2 blocks. Okay, there's actually a pattern here that we want to notice. Let's look closely at the decimal places. Here in 23%, the decimal is here, and then it ended up here. For 6%, the decimal started here and ended up here. For 200%, the decimal started here and ended up there. Let's have a quiz behind what's going on with this pattern. What do you notice?